As of now, you are there and you can see my screen, which is a white blank screen. Okay. And why we are here for today? So we will be having an episode out of many of the Centemar. Okay. Where for today we will be discussing and spending our time, our dinner time, our appetizing time. So as we are meeting for the first time, I'm going to discuss with you the mechanical. Okay, sure. The mechanics portion of the physics, okay, which you have in ninth grade. It includes understanding motion. Okay, it includes understanding laws of motion. And it also includes understanding gravitation and all. Right or not? This is at least where we have done in the class. For few batches where I met in the last 2 weeks, yes, we have also crossed the line of work, power and energy. Okay, so now I'll be dominantly talking about these three parts because this is common for all. I'm not going to talk about this work, power and energy. Fine. Now, you know that. Now, you know that. Okay. When we talk about motion, laws of motion and gravitation, a major name exists over there of Uncle Newton, right or not? Uncle Newton, in the very first chapter, have discussed with us about the three equations of motion, which are V is equals to AT plus U or U plus AT will work. S is equals to UT plus half AT square, and V square is equals to U square plus 2AS. Right? So, if you remember the classroom teachings, either you've been in direct conversation with me or you've been in direct conversation with someone else, okay, then you know that through this, the primary numericals were done and they were widely initially classified under horizontal motion and vertical motion. Clear? Post that, we jumped into the application of similar equations and vectors, okay, and we completed projectile motion. Yes or no? Clear?
Sir, no. we didn't do this with Dhiraj, sir.
Okay, projectile is not done?
No, sir.
No problem. Thank you very much for the information. But anyway, what I'm going to cover today is primarily first thing with horizontal and vertical motion. Okay? So, you are very much aware about the fact. I'll tackle the three chapters in three parts. Okay? So, this is the sole concept which exists in understanding motion, excluding the definition part, right or not? You know what is velocity, you know what is acceleration, you know what is displacement, what is distance, how distance and displacement are different from each other and all, right or not? All these things you are thoroughly aware about. Clear? Now, when we look for horizontal and vertical motion and when we study them, what thing we should remember is primarily that this vertical motion, okay, is by default supported by the Chhotu Ji Maharaj, right or not? Sure. Clear? Whereas in horizontal motion, until and unless stated, acceleration is zero. Am I clear? So, until and unless stated otherwise, the acceleration will remain zero in horizontal motion. In vertical motion, yes, there is an acceleration due to gravity. Say, for example, I will ask you a very, very simple question. That, dear friends, say, for example, an object is tossed vertically up with 20 meter per second. An object is tossed vertically up with 20 meter per second. Simple question, that in what time it will reach the maximum height? What will be the maximum height? Clear? Can you please answer me as quick as possible? In what time will it reach the maximum height? And what is the maximum height? few people
are. Time is 2 seconds.
Time is 2 seconds, and 40 is the maximum height by Aidan Thomas. Okay, but time is 2 seconds by whom? Can you please state your name so that it will be easier?
Pranav.
Pranav, time is 2 seconds is absolutely correct. Aidan, are you sure about the line that the height covered is 40 meters? 20, sorry. Good. Aidan, now I received it. Okay, height is 20 meters. See, there are direct ways like U square by 2G, which can be applied. Okay. If you don't want to remember every single bit of a result, then you can go by the simple relation, right? Why? Because you know that, okay, what has to be calculated is, what has to be calculated. So U square by 2G is the formula. Suppose you don't want to remember everything, then yes, what will you do? You will think, okay, dear, what is asked is H, which is analogous with S, which can be calculated from these two equations. Okay. As you know, time as of now, you can put even over here and get the answer. Clear? If at all you don't know the time, then directly this is your answer, because you know that finally the velocity is going to be zero and it will be nothing but U square plus 2. Acceleration while going up is minus G and S is H. And this is where this result came out. Very good. Easy. Done. Now my question to you is that, okay, you know that the maximum height covered by this object is 20 meters. Cool. Now my question is, for the same part, in what time will it reach half the maximum height, which is actually 10 meters? So my question is, what time will it reach 10 meters? In what time will it reach 10 meters? Half second is wrong answer. Please try again, Vibhav. 1 second is also wrong answer. The reason is, again, think about it. 1 second would have been the answer if the motion would have been a uniform motion. Is it a uniform motion? You will say aloud in your soul that no. As acceleration is a non-zero entity, this cannot be a uniform motion. Yes or no? Clear or not? Sure. So this is not a uniform motion. That's why equal distance won't be covered in equal time. Yes, something root to Keshav. Yes, yes, yes. It is somewhere around it. But please recorrect your equation and then you may get a very good answer. Chalo. Then I guess instead of investing time, let me only solve the thing. Okay. From chat again. 2 seconds is not the answer because dear, 2 seconds is the time which was taken by you to, which was taken by you to, right or not, to go to the maximum height of 20. So see, how will you do? You have to calculate time. Again, the same approach. I am telling you a very common approach. Keep it simple. No need to remember every bit of the formula. Simple, simple, simple. You say that, sir, I have to calculate time. Time can be calculated either by this equation or by this equation. Okay, if I want to calculate by this equation, then I need initial velocity, which I know. Okay, I need to know acceleration, which I know. But I don't know the final velocity. Someone has sent. T is equals to U by G. Who told you this, yaar? T is equals to U by G. Where is it written? Sir, for vertical motion, T is equals to U by G. Literally. Matlab, for any, see, irrespective of what distance is covered, time is always U by G. No, na? This time, what you are talking about is the time taken to cover the maximum height. Time taken to reach the maximum height, beta. Aniket Gupta ji. Bhul gaye yaar. Ye kab ho gaya? This time which you are writing is the time taken to reach the maximum. Maximum. Main maximum nahi puch raha. I'm not talking about maximum. I am talking about half the height. Half the height bolte thus. Okay? Sure? Clear? Chalo. So, now back to agenda. What we are talking about is, ki bhai, I have to calculate time. Okay. So this equation is not there. Why? Because I don't know the final velocity at 10. Okay, sure. So now I'm going to use this equation. And yes, yeah, u is known to me. A is known to me, which is g. Okay, and s is also known to me, 10 meters. So I'll write that dear 10 will be equal to 20t plus half minus 10 and t square. Just for simplification of calculation, because my primary motive is to make you comfortable with the calculation part, I'm using acceleration due to gravity as 10. Okay. Now, isn't it a quadratic equation? In polynomial chapter, haven't you done solving a quadratic equation? Yes. You will rearrange the same equation and will write that 0 is equal to, yes or no, 5t square minus 20t plus 10. Okay. You can take 5 common, you will write t square minus 4t plus 2 is equal to 0. Now you can solve this equation by several methods. One of the favorite method of mine is the method of Sridharacharya. Sridharacharya, as the name indicate, okay, an Indian mathematician, told that yeah, if there is a quadratic equation of the form ax square plus bx plus c, then x will be equal to minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So when you compare this equation with this format, then you get t equal to minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a, right? So you'll get 2 plus root 2 or 2 minus root 2. Now, why this question is important? Because this question gives you a very good point to discuss about. Very, very good point to discuss about. Guys, think. What am I asking? I am asking you that, okay, dear, when I toss this object up, it went to a height of 20 meters and is, okay, sure, fine. In between this, what I am asking is, what is the time to reach 10 meters? And you said, several chats, why Sharaja sir, don't do us like that. Are yeah, Keshav, don't. Sridharacharya is easy. If you want, you can also factorize this. I don't have any problem. Mr. Gupta, it is peaceful for you. Good. Sridharacharya is lit. For quadratic equations, Sridharacharya is the ultimate solution. Okay. So, t square minus 4t plus 2. Okay. Post Sridharacharya application gave you two results. T equal to 2 plus root 2 and t is equal to 2 minus root 2. And I am explaining you both the results because both are real number. Say for example, one time would have been negative, then we would have easily ignored it, right? Yes or no? We would have easily ignored it, saying time cannot be negative, but here both are positive. 2 plus root 2 and 2 minus root 2. So how are we going to justify this? Because both are possible answers. So see, when the movement started, okay, 0, it reached to a height of 20 and again coming back. Here the time taken is 2 seconds, yes or no, to reach here. Fine. And this is 10 over here and this is 10 over here as well. So understand there. To reach over here, it took a time of 2 minus root 2. And starting from here, to reach over here, it took a time of 2 plus root 2. Easy? Sure. From here, you can also say that, okay, sir, the time taken to reach or cover this distance either while going up or while coming down is same. Yes or no? And this is where my next explanation is leading to. Got it or not? Yes or no? Sure. Fine. Chalo. So, if you have, then I am erasing the screen. Okay. Sure. For your support, what I am doing is I am keeping it safe for me so that I can share it as the revision notes. Okay. Now, back to agenda. My question is clear to you. Okay. As of now, the maximum height reached by that object was in 2 seconds. The maximum height is 20 meters. The time taken to recover the distance of 10 meters is 2 minus root 2 while going up and 2 plus root 2 while going this way. Yes or no? This is clear. Okay, sorted. Fine. Now the question is, same thing. Same thing. Okay. From a platform, from the same height, suppose the object is coming down from here. Yes or no? This is again the same height of 20 meters. The same object. Okay. Now it's coming down only. It's coming down only. My question number one is, what is the displacement covered in the first second? What is the displacement covered in the first second? Simple. Three more questions. I'll switch the topic. What is the displacement covered in the first second? Or 23 charts. Nothing much important instead of Tushar sir's instruction. Thank you, Tushar bhai. And someone answered 5 meters, which is good. Direct application of the equation. S is equals to ut plus half a t square. Yes or no? Sure, t is 1. So answer is 5 meters. In the same way, if I'll ask, what is the total displacement covered in 2 seconds? Not in second second. My question is in 2 seconds. So your answer will be, sir, the same. 0 plus half a t square. Yes or no? 20. Which leads to a conclusion that, okay, dear, what is the distance covered in the second? And now you can directly answer, sir, 15. So can you please very quickly answer me two things? What is the displacement covered directly in the third second? Kabir, 25. Aniket Gupta, 25. Very good. Good. 25 Kavir, good. Keshav, 25, good. Surya, 25, good. And yes, 25 is the answer. Okay. Sure. And can you please tell me the ratio of these three terms? Touch, and room. 1:3:5. Can you expect the next one? Can you explain the other ones? Isn't it easy? Oh, sorry. Easy, right? 1:3:7, series of all numbers. That means in consecutive seconds, if you want, if you are interested, you can note down these things. In consecutive seconds, the displacement covered has a ratio of 1:3:5:7 and so on. So if I'll simply ask you for closing this topic, that if an object is dropped from a very significantly high point, so what is the displacement covered in the 11th second? For the one who will answer first, chocolate. Aiden, wrong. Aiden, you are making many silly mistakes. Pranav M. You are correct. Pranav M. I received my first answer from Pranav M. And Pranav is going to get the chocolate. It will reach to you, Pranav. Don't worry. Good. those. So, how he did it? Many people are responding now. Great, 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 good. How he did it? He said, yeah, sir, in this series, the 11th odd number will be 22. Sure.
So 21.
21. Okay. He multiplied 5 to it and he got 505. Okay. Easy. Sure. Good. For everyone, this is the explanation. For those who understand, fine. So this is a good information about the vertical motion. Okay. Now we are moving toward. We are skipping projectile as of now, not in this class, but in a I'll take up next section. We'll only talk about projectile motions. Okay. Sure. This session I am moving a bit further, and now we are going to talk for next 5 to 10 minutes about average velocity on horizontal, not on vertical ground, on horizontal plane. Okay. Sure. Chalo, fine. Now, the question is, let's go into the vertical of average velocity. Average velocity. Okay. Sure. Don't whistle. I can hear. Now, velocity average by its very definition is what? The total displacement covered upon the total time taken. Yes or no? When it talk about speed, the displacement just gets displaced by distance. Yes or no? Clear? When we were in class, we have done some special types of these, primarily two. Average velocity in case of equal distance covered. Average velocity in case of equal durations. Okay. Say for example, two parts of a journey, both of equal distance. Okay. Someone. Okay. Thank you. Both of equal length are covered by speed V1 and V2 or velocity V1 and V2. As we are as of now going only in one dimension, speed and velocity are same. Okay. So the average velocity will be given by 2V1V2 upon V1 plus V2. Easy? Sure. Okay. And then if there is equal duration, that mean what? Please, if you are under like in control of erasing it, can you please? A journey of total T hours is covered in T by 2 hours and T by 2 hours with the speed or velocity V1 and V2. Then the average speed or velocity is directly the average. So for my dear friends, because we always tell you things of elevation, suppose it becomes 3, so your answer will be 3 V1 V2 V3 upon LCM V1 V2 plus V2 V3 plus V3 V1. Yes or no? Suppose this goes 3. So V1 plus V2 plus V3 by 3. Am I clear? Sir, I do not understand. Aditya Gupta ji, very good. Which part? Which part you did not understand? Can you please ping me again? Yeah, multiplication of 5. Kabir, yes, multiplication of 5. Aniket Gupta is stating a formula. Beautiful. Okay, the ratio. Yes. Okay, I'll re-help you out. For the first one, beta, which the fool, my dear friend. Okay, you are owing my name. So, for the first one, which one? Can you please be a bit? See, you have to just type. So, it's easy if you'll. Okay. Sir, could you explain how you got V1 plus V2 by 2 again. Okay. If you want, I can derive it. You want the derivation of it. It will take a bit time, but I'll do that. Don't worry. both if you need this and this. Okay. As of now, you have only asked this, so I'll do this only. So, suppose a journey, total span is T, so denominator is T. Speed 1 and speed 2. So, you don't know as of now what is the total distance. So, you'll say speed is equal to distance upon time. So, distance is equal to speed into time. But is this time TT only? No. The time is half of T and half of T, two equal spans. So, you'll say, okay, total distance is V1 T by 2 plus V2 T by 2. T by 2 common, T say T, udi maar ga, brum, answer is V1 plus V2 by 2. Easy. And similar will be for 3 and all, right? Chat kahan hai? Okay, now for the D by 2 case. Okay, no problem. I hope as of now, this case is clear. V1 plus V2 by 2. Now I'm talking about the D by 2 wala case. Okay. So think. Equal displacement or distance. Okay. D by 2, D by 2, V1, V2. So see, you don't know the total time, but you know the total distance. D. Total time. So speed is equals to distance upon time. So time is equals to distance upon speed. Similarly, next time is equals to distance upon speed. Put it over here. D by 2V1 plus D by 2V2. Take the LCM and it will go up and 2, 2 common and get cancelled and D, D common and get cancelled and you will get 2V1, V2. V1 plus V2. Yes or no? Okay, 1 is to 3 is to 5. Yes, Nafal, you did not understood. 1 is to 3 is to 5. Don't worry, I'll redo it. Aniket, don't distract me. I can anytime go to YouTube. This was for Aniket M. Okay, so back to agenda. Guys, if you want to understand the ratio wala thing, I'm just giving you a quick view. Calculate displacement in first second, you will say 5. Calculate displacement in second second. So you will say total displacement in 2 seconds minus total displacement in 1 second. Answer will be 15. Total third, if I ask total displacement in 3 seconds minus total displacement in 2 seconds, answer will be 25. When you take the ratio 5 ones, 5 threes and 5 fives, this is how it comes. Okay. Don't test the patience, dear. If you are doing it knowingly, don't test the patience, please. Okay. Sure. Let it be in a happy mood. Sure. Let's not the dinner be more salty. Okay. Please. If you're doing it knowingly, don't do that again. Okay. I'll try because I have to again distract myself, reach over here and do it. Where is an annotation, eraser and done. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So this is about the average velocity wala game. Okay. A simple question, quick answer. Simple question and quick answer. Okay. A journey of 100 kilometers. A journey of 100 kilometers was covered in 3 parts. Okay. Sure. Fine. 50, 25, 25. For this part, the speed was 40. For this part, the speed was 60. And again, this part, the speed is 40 kilometer per hour by default. Here as well and here as well. Clear? May I please know the average velocity? The first one to answer will get a chocolate. Where is chat? Yaar, I have to read Bachcha Log's answer. Okay, sir. Aditi K. Try. Answer, answer, answer. The first one to answer will get a chocolate. 5 by 7 kilometer per hour is not possible there. 48, no. Kesha, 46.66. 13 kilometer per hour. 2.29. Na. You can also answer in fractions. Don't worry. 140 by 3 sounds something. 39.4. No, 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 no.
Sir, it's 46.6 bar.
Yes, 140 by 3 or 46.6 bar, which was actually answered. Keshav, I guess, answered the first.
Sir, what about 43.6?
No, dear. Check the calculation, Pranav. Before Keshav... Oh, oh, oh. Kushagra answered it first. Kushagra. See, guys, no unfair thing. I'm just Keshav. Are 5 by 7. Keshav, na? Ha. So Keshav answered it first. Keshav, buddy, you'll get it. Don't worry. Okay, too many Indranagar aspirants. Maybe directly or indirectly. Okay. Chalo. So now, got it? This was about average velocity. I said I'll talk about it for maximum 10 minutes. We had a conversation of 15 minutes. Okay? Chalo, fine. Back to agenda. Clear? Fine. Anyone? Okay with linear motion as of now? We have not discussed about yet relative motion and projectile motion. Okay? So, chalo. Now we are going into laws of motion. Okay? And this is going to be interesting now. Because this is my favorite chapter. Might be yours too. So when we talk about laws of motion, again, a great contribution by Uncle Newton to the world. I'm not discussing projectile, Aditi. Promise, I'm not discussing projectile tomorrow. Okay. Law of Newton can be said, Uncle, but it is actually he is being modest. Said that it be laws of motion given by Uncle Newton. So, what happens is simple. Three laws.
Aye, sir.
First law, also called law of inertia. Tells you that until unless you are pinned by your parents or us, you won't study. Clear? Second law. Law of conservation of momentum can be said, but actually law which defines motion. Rate of change of linear momentum and force are directly proportional to each other. This law only will in future become F is equals to ma for rigid bodies, and a bigger expression when you will be in 11th grade. Okay, you will read about a bigger expression for bodies which will be changing their mass post application of force. As of now, you will be dealing with only rigid bodies. And that's the reason that clear? How will mass change? Beta rocket? See, in general, what happens is if I'll push you, your mass won't change. Else all the gyms will be closed. People, in order to reduce mass, will only be referring dhakkas. De dhakka, right? But no, that's not the case. What is the case? That rigid bodies as we are don't change their mass in general post application of force. But there are bodies which may change their mass post application of force or by some thing from themselves or externally applied, like a rocket. You know, a rocket propulses by Newton's third law, every action will have an equal and opposite reaction. But as the fuel burns out, don't you think that its mass is reducing? Yes or no? So, yeah. So, there are bodies which do change their mass post application of force. We are as of now not at all talking about them. We are as of now not at all talking about them. Okay? Now back to agenda. Second law and the third law states every action will have an equal and opposite reaction. Force acted by two on one will be having equal application of force from one on two, but in opposite direction. Clear or not? When we have a discussion of these three laws, yes, what we discuss about are their applications. Yes or no? Sure. Examples and all. When we talk about the numericals associated with them, so I ask a general question. What it is? That suppose on a floor there are two blocks. This is of 3 kg. This is of 1 kg. I am applying a force of 20 Newton. I am applying a force of 20 Newton here to pull this up. Simple question. Simple and very simple question. What is the tension in the string? Not in this direction. I literally mean within this domain, what is the tension in the string? Ten. 60. Something, but it disproves the law of gravity. What? Newton's third law, second law, what? 60 Newton, kaise ho jayega, bhai? 60 Newton is not possible, Pranav RNR. 60 Newton, how is it possible? Reason being, I am applying 20 Newton. How can tension be more than the applied force? Aniket Gupta, 20, Yash, 10, and all. Let's see. So guys, simple thing that when this is applied, the total acceleration possessed by the body is equal to total force applied by total mass, which is equal to 5. Yes or no? That means force utilized by this block, I am writing in orange, or I am writing in another color here. Give me a good color. Not a good color, but okay. 5 into 1. Yes or no? Mass into acceleration. So our remaining force goes here. 15 Newton. The force experienced by this block is only by tension. Na? That's why tension is equals to 15 Newton. How we achieve this is mathematically, okay, termed as free body diagram. I hope all of you are thoroughly aware about this term. Kahan chat? Abhi chat ka hai? What is tension? Aditya Gupta. Okay. Sir, even in buoyancy, Newton's third law of motion comes into play as a solid applies pressure on. Yes, correct. What is tension, Aditya Gupta? Very good question. Anyone else? Sir, what is tension? Again, Aditya Gupta. Sorry, dear. I missed your initial request. So, first thing, what is tension? So, Aditya, tension is the name of force given to a restoring force actually. Say for example, I'll simply ask you a question. Very, very simple question. Say for example, this is a ceiling. From the ceiling, if there is a mass hanging down, yes or no? Clear? Then I'll ask you, what is the force acting on this mass? So you will say, sir, the force acting on this mass is mg. Now, my dear friend, as this is a string, this is a mass, this force is mg. By this intuition, this object should go down by Newton's uncle's first law, no? Because the total force acting is unbalanced and is in one direction. Yes or no? But you see the wall, object doesn't go down. Hence, as the object is not going down, then there is surely something existing which is canceling this mg down. In order to cancel, please remove the purple thing. In order to cancel this, the thing which we are assuming should exist vertically upward, opposite to this. And exactly in this string, you know that there exists a stretch in the opposite direction, right or not? When you pull a string toward you, it tends to stretch back within itself, right? Restore its shape. That restoring force in a non-stretchable string is tension. Clear or not? Aditya, have I done my part? Sorry, Aditya ji, sorry. But I hope. Yes or no? One force opposing the other. Correct? Balancing it. Okay, guys. So back to agenda, tension. So how did we achieve this? Is by the help of free body diagram. Free body diagram. Okay. Please see all these things, because this is something which can't happen by mistake. Okay. So this is drawn. So don't, please don't check patience. You know? Now, back to agenda. Free body diagram. Free body diagram is drawn.
Okay, you read the definition
of tension. Okay. So tension is the force developed in a body in general, string, on application of a force. This force primarily should be stretching force. So when we try to stretch a string, it tends to restore its shape. And this restoring force is tension minded. Clear or not? Okay. Now back to agenda, dear. Tension and free body diagram. So see, when we look at a body on which force are being applied, so I am first drawing body number one, like that is the block of 1 kg. Okay, if you'll see it, I am applying a force of 20 newtons here. Okay, because of tension, there is a force. Clear? And also this body is having an acceleration here in this direction. Suppose this acceleration is A and the mass is M. Then you will write an equation that mass into acceleration, the total force, is a result of supportive force minus opposing force. Yes or no? Supportive force minus opposing force. This equation is called free body equation. This diagram is called free body diagram. These diagrams help us out in to write it, the force balancing equations, the second law of motion equations. Clear? This is what we have written, is an equation balancing all the force. Clear? Sure. We have covered in the classroom, as we are many over here, so that's why I have just given a revision over. Sir, can I leave the class? I have to charge my phone. Only 3%. Thank you. Okay, Aditi K. Chalo. Even we are going to complete it in the next 2 or 3 minutes. Aditya ji, Again, the free body diagram, I'll explain. No, don't worry. Yes, Nafel. Free body diagram, what is it? Okay, I'm re-explaining it, dear. Kushagra, you wanted to say something? I didn't receive any of your texts and all. If without the string, there won't be any tension. Na? Tension exists in a stretching body. They are tending to stretch body. Okay, I am explaining one more time the free body diagram. See, as of now, I have kept this body individually over here. And taking into consideration all the forces acting on this body. I should also draw this. But as we are considering motion in this direction, I have not drawn G. You will say, sir, actually MG is also acting. And from the surface, there is a normal reaction also acting. So in this case, as the object is not moving like this vertically, so you can say, okay, N is equal to MG. Normal reaction from the surface is equal to the acceleration, like M into acceleration due to gravity. Pranav, raise hand. What happened, Pranav? Sir, how do you calculate the tension in the 3 kg and 1 kg question after finding both forces? That's what I'm telling you, dear. See, here as there are two bodies only and there are very less number of like only two forces, by this equation only you can calculate. You got this equation? Yes or no? The acceleration this is moving is the total force on it is M into A. And this M into A is equal to supportive force minus opposing force. Clear? Now, by the formula that acceleration is equal to total force upon total mass of the system, you got acceleration is 5. And you are also aware about the line that mass is equal to 1 kg. You put it over here, 1 kg into 5. So 5 Newton is equal to 20 minus tension. So tension is equal to 15 Newton. Easy. I just did it. Hashtag loner KRM for life. As of now, we have not given any friction. Not yet. Surely when I'll give friction, then the things will also roll down. Okay. Clear. When I'll give friction, then the things will, an arrow will also participate over here from the friction line. Not individually normal equal to 0 or mg equal to 0. The net influence from normal and mg equal to 0. The total influence caused by normal and mg is 0 because both are balancing each other. Okay, yes? Can it be in the different direction? I didn't get you link from BTOW, dear. What in different direction? The tension, the force or what? Tension. Guys, for this body, as you are pulling this way, the tension in the string will be this way. Pretty obvious, as I told you, tension is a restoring thing. So as you are pulling this object this way, the tension in the string will be this way. Clear? Sure. For a simple understanding, tension, okay, will always oppose the body. Will always in the opposite direction of the body. Like this. This is the body, then tension will go here. Okay? This is the body, tension will go away from it. Clear? Sure. Chalo. Now, time's up. Surely, I think that what I had planned, we have not covered that much. I hope you guys have enjoyed it, learned something out of it. Surely, another 1 hour session we'll have. We'll proceed from here only. Okay. Also, feel free to state your request. Okay. Like if you want to understand, sir, as of now, instead of going for a back end chapter of chapter 1, chapter 2 and all. Clear? Feel free to tell, sir, as of now in our school, gravitation or work power energy or sound is going on. So can we? Clear? Can we have a discussion of those topics and all? Clear? Don't spam the screen again. Okay? Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Good day.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Bye, sir.